aspirin affects blood clotting. It makes blood clot less readily. In fact, that's exactly the reason that we use it for people who have had heart attacks or strokes, to make the blood clot less readily. And anytime you use a medicine that affects blood clotting, you get some benefits or some things that you want, but you also get things that you may not want, such as bleeding. And it turns out that that aspirin probably causes more hospitalizations for a drug side effect than any other medicine. Not that it's the most dangerous medicine that we use, but by the virtue of the fact that it's used by so many people. So even though the risk is fairly small in an individual person, the collective risk is pretty high. There's a lot of hospitalizations related to bleeding that is either caused or worsened by aspirin. We would have to treat 10,000 patients with aspirin to prevent 5 events. That's an awful lot of patients to treat, and the benefit is pretty small. At the same time, if we treated those 10,000 patients with aspirin, we would cause about 6 or 7 extra bleeding events. And so those 6 or 7 extra bleeding events would kind of balance out any benefit that we got. The guidelines that were recently released by the American College of Cardiology and American Heart Association weren't just aspirin guidelines. They were guidelines about the prevention of heart and vascular disease. And I'd encourage anybody who's interested to look at the emphasis in these new guidelines, and the emphasis is really on a healthy lifestyle. So I'm getting enough exercise and, at least 150 minutes a week of exercise, maintaining your body weight, paying attention to the types of foods that you eat. So there's a thing called the DASH, D-A-S-H diet, and it has to do with using more fruits, vegetables, fish, and lean meats. And less sugar, saturated fat, and fried foods. What I would say to somebody is, if your doctor advised you to take aspirin, I think you should talk to your doctor about whether you should continue in light of the new guidelines.